Kachuk Adventure was absolutely stellar in organizing this adventure. You know, at no point was I worried about going up on a very small airplane, and at no point was I worried about being on this sliver of an island in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean just before winter hits. It was really lovely. We had five people on the tour. And so it was really intimate and small, and we got to get to know each other. And so rather than these large tours where there's 100 people or even 25 people, a tour with four or five very interested and keen outdoorsy types is really wonderful. And I much prefer smaller adventure tours than large adventure tours. We were fortunate that Zoe was able to take us around and teach us about all the different plants and berries, and how the horses use all the variety of plant as part of their diet. I didn't expect to see so many horses all in one location, and at one point we were all around this watering hole and we didn't realize there was another band that came up from behind. And so in essence we were surrounded by about 15 horses. And we were sort of stuck and we couldn't really move. We were frozen on this little grassy knoll. So it was really kind of cool because you didn't know what the horses were going to do. And I never expected that. I thought I would see five or six of them, but I never thought I'd be in the middle of 15 horses. And they were just doing their thing. It was beautiful. Sable Island was a lot more than I could ever have expected. I've traveled quite a bit and I've never quite seen any place around the world with such natural beauty that hasn't been altered by people. Everywhere you walk, you can see that nature is just doing its thing and we don't need to fix it, we don't need to beautify it. It's really quite lovely, and of all the places I've ever been, this is really one of the best for nature that I've ever seen. It was really worth the wait. It's been many years that I've been trying to do this, so it was really a really good day.